Hello children, today we are going to do a grammar topic. The name of the topic is noun and its kinds. What is a noun? A noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. For example, person, Mr. Modi, our Prime Minister, Mr. Sharma, Mr. Raina, Mr. Patel, Mr. Shah, Rahul, Dina, all are the names of the persons. Next, place. For example, Ahmedabad, Chennai, Bangalore, school, market, or a mall, all are the names of the places. Next, animal. Tiger, dog, cat, elephant, all are the names of the animals. Next, thing, flag, a precious thing, isn't it? Or your bag, your box, your bottle, your pencil, all are the names of the things. Following are the kinds of the nouns we are going to study. Common nouns, proper nouns, countable nouns, uncountable nouns, and collective nouns. We will begin with common nouns and proper nouns. Common noun is the name given to a person, place, or a thing in general, whereas proper noun is the name given to a person or a place in particular. For example, country. Country is a common noun, but if we talk about India, Malaysia, Poland, it means we are talking about the particular countries. So these are proper nouns. City. City is a common noun. But if we talk about Mumbai, Delhi, Bengaluru, it means we are talking about the particular cities. Mountain. Mountain is a common noun. But if we talk about Mount Everest, Himalayas, it means we are talking about the particular mountain ranges. So these are proper nouns. School. School is the common noun. But if we talk about DPS Bhopal, Olive International, it means we are talking about the particular schools. So these are proper nouns. River. River is a common noun. But if we talk about Ganga, Yamuna, Sabarmati, it means we are talking about the particular rivers. So these are proper nouns. Festival. The word festival is a common noun. We celebrate many festivals in our country. But if we say Diwali, Holi, Christmas, it means we are talking about the particular festivals. So these are proper nouns. Child. Child is a common noun. But when we say Rahul, Ria, Tina, it means we are talking about the particular children. So these are proper nouns. Now the children, I think it must be clear to you that common noun is the name given to a person, place or a thing in general, and proper name is the name given to a person or a place in particular. Children, you need to remember proper noun starts with the capital letter. Let's begin with the countable nouns. A countable noun is a noun which can be counted by using numbers. For example, one book, four books. They have a singular and a plural form. A or an can be used in singular form. Indefinite article A can be used with the word starts with the consonant sound. Children, do you know how many letters are there in English alphabet? There are 26 letters. Out of 26 letters, 21 are the consonants and 5 are the vowels. Vowels are A, E, I, O, U. Here, indefinite article A can be used with the word starts with the consonant sound. For example, cup. So it is a cup in a singular form and the plural of it is cups. Indefinite article an can be used with the word starts with the vowel sound. For example, umbrella starts with U, which is a vowel. So, in a singular form, it is an umbrella, and the plural of it is umbrellas. Now, uncountable nouns. An uncountable noun is a noun that cannot be counted with numbers. They may be the names for ideas or qualities or for physical objects that are too small to be counted. For example, liquids like tea, coffee, water, or powders like salt, fluor, or gases like smoke, fog, air, all are uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns are used with the singular verb. For example, the furniture in this room is very attractive. Another, the furniture in this room are very attractive. So the right answer is, the furniture in this room is very attractive because uncountable nouns are used with the singular verb. Another example, this luggage look heavy. Another, this luggage looks heavy. The right answer is, this luggage looks heavy because looks is the singular verb which goes with the uncountable noun luggage over here. We do not usually use the indefinite articles a or an with uncountable nouns. We cannot say an information, but we can say some information. I need your attention over here, children. To count uncountable nouns, we have to use a unit of measurement, that is a measured word. For example, instead of saying a bread, it is right to say a loaf of bread. Similarly, a bowl of rice, a spoon of sugar, a glass of water. To make it more clear, we use many with countable nouns and much with uncountable nouns. For example, how many rupees are there in your pocket? Rupees is a countable noun and we have used the word many with it. Next, how much money do you have in the bank? Money is an uncountable noun and we have used the word much with the word money. There are many apples kept in the basket. Apples are the countable nouns and we have used the word many with it. Next is, how much fruit did you buy? Fruit is an uncountable noun and we have used the word much with it. We have reached to the fifth kind of nouns, that is collective nouns. A collective noun is a noun that refers to a collection or a group of multiple people, animals, or things. Even though a collective noun refers to multiple individuals, it still usually functions as a singular noun in a sentence. This is because it is technically referring to one thing, the group as a whole. Here are some examples of collective nouns. A school of fish. Can you see the children in the pic? There are many fish together in a grove. So we call it a school of fish. In the another pic, you can see some lions sitting together in a grove. We call it a pride of lions. You must remember, a singular verb is used in collective nouns. For example, the family is on a holiday. Family is a collective noun. You know, family in which a group of people live together, we cannot say the family are on a holiday, but we use a singular verb with the collective nouns. So family is a collective noun. We have used here the singular verb with this. So the answer is The family is on a holiday. Another example, the crowd is cheering. You know, the crowd, it's a group of people together. So, but we use the singular verb with that, and that is the crowd is cheering. It's a quiz time now. Choose the collective nouns in the following sentences and write in your notebook. I'll read that out for you. The jury took a long time to give the verdict. You have the choices: jury, verdict, time. Second, the army was on march for several days. Choices are march, army, several. Next, the audience rose and applauded the performance. Your choices are performance, audience, rose. Next, the band played 5 numbers before they took a break. Your choices are band, played, break. The 5th question is, the team played as hard as they could. And the choices are team, hard, played. Next, the school choir performed at the All City Talent. The choices are school, choir, talent. Number 7. Raina's family is going to Disneyland this summer. Choices are family, summer, Disneyland. Number 8. The whole school is attending an assembly right now. The choices are school, assembly, whole. As you have completed the quiz, show the answers to the judge, your mom or your dad, and tell to give you the numbers for the right answers. Now you can see how much you know about the collective nouns. In the next slides, there are answers, but don't peep before you get your marks. That's all for today. Thank you so very much.